Do you know the first GMO produce was approved by FDA in year 1982, and that was human insulin to treat human diabetes. Today I'm going to talk about GMOs, that is genetically modified organisms. You must have seen these logos on food products available in the market. Now, what does these logos mean? These logos are there to differentiate their product from other products available in the markets. As you can see, the non-GMO projects, and there are some GMO projects too. Now, these logos are the market strategy to present to differentiate their product from other products and also to increase the prices of their products. Now, what does a GM food means? GM food is derived from organisms whose genetic material has been modified. These are some of the examples of genetically modified foods available in the markets. I got this information from WHO website. Now, there is an ongoing debate between GMO versus non-GMO. Technically, both these products are, in terms of nutritional value, they are same. The only difference is that the non-GMO products are higher in prices compared to GMO products. Now, what is the need for GM food? Increase in population. As we know, the population is increasing, and if the population is increasing, there is an increase in hunger. As you can see in this graph, in year 2020, the population is around 7.8 billion and it's estimated to be 15.6 billion by the year of 2050. So because the population is increasing, the number of people are increasing, the hunger is increasing, and we need more food to feed them. Climate change due to global warming. The main reason behind the climate change is the global warming. As we experienced by last year, there was not much rainfall, and the less rainfall has impacted the agriculture field. Most of these crops are modified to reduce the negative effects of insects or weeds. Now, GM foods are much more powerful as compared to the regular foods available in the market. It is way to enhance food nutrition quality. Now, these are some of the benefits of using GM foods. First of all, shrinking our environmental footprint. What does environmental footprint mean? Environmental footprint means the effect of a person or a company on environment is what the environmental footprint is. GM foods actually allows farmers to grow more crop on less land while using fewer pesticides and less water. In United States, GM crops resulted in pesticides use reduction of 46.4 million pounds in 2003, whereas worldwide this reduction was around 9%. GM foods also lower the price of foods. As I mentioned, the farmers grow more crops on less land, they need less pesticides and less water, which in turn reduces the price of product for the consumers. Because they require fewer pesticides, land and water, GM crops help keep food production costs down, resulting in lower prices for consumers, alleviating hunger and malnutrition around the world. GMOs have helped feed more than 300 million Americans and a global population of 7 billion, of which 1 in 8 suffer from hunger and malnutrition. The success story. Virus-resistant papaya. As you can see, this is the disease papaya. GM papaya was actually bred to resist a deadly plant disease which has rescued the Hawaiian papaya industry and saved livelihoods of thousands of small farmers. Now, non-browning of apples. There is an enzyme called polyphenol oxidase which is found in apple, and nobody knows the actual benefits of this enzyme, but this enzyme actually results in browning of apples when the peeled apples are exposed to air. So non-browning of apples is used to reduce the food waste and increase consumption. A technique which is known as gene slicing, actually the scientist actually goes and change the gene of, they actually change the gene for this enzyme and make their apples last longer. The third story is about the herbicide tolerant crops. As you can see, these are the crops without weeds, and they are very much tolerant to herbicides. So weeds are one of the biggest obstacles between farmers and successful harvest, because weeds compete with crops for nutrients, for water and for sunlight. Herbicides are used to kill weeds, and also these herbicides also affect crops. So if the herbicides can also kill crops. So if the GM crops, they are herbicides tolerant, so they can actually tolerate a large amount of herbicides. So I got this information from AMA website, that is American Medical Association website. The American Medical Association and the World Health Organization have concluded that genetically modified foods are safe for consumers. Studies have shown that GMOs have no effect on organ health, offspring, and on or our DNA, and have no allergy related to these foods. Thank you for watching my video. Hope you can select the right product in future. Thank you.